The auditors saw certain certificates before the 21st of June. Well, we didn't get the exact dates. I've got to be exact. Yes, before the 21st of June, the date on which I severed my connection with the company.
The auditors
certificates that they saw then were 100% authentic.
No.
Yes.
In April 1966, when you were in charge of this
company... Sorry, that statement is inaccurate.
I'm afraid it's not. It's true.
No, can't be. I'm prepared to have the auditor up here, and if he says so on oath, I'm prepared to have him up for perjury.
I'm afraid you're wrong, because the fact...
No, the fact is absolutely clear.
The fact...
This has been one of the grossest misrepresentations by the Sunday newspapers that made such a hoo-ha about this.
Why haven't you sued those on that specific point?
I've been aware, as you know, the writs are
back
already...
back with the heart attack again.
No. Back with the heart attack is not the... Let's not bring that... I've been aware, I said. I've only just got back. The writs are ready. We were waiting to finish your show.
To serve us with one, too.
Oh, well, why not? Why not?
Yes, it'll all be fun. That's what worries me about you. It's all fun to you, isn't it?
But of course it's all fun.
Come down here.
Certainly.
Come and sit on a stool over here, would you, Dr. Swindra?
Slowly, slowly. Catchy monkey. Now.
Do sit down.
I hope the stool's not fixed.
No.
Right?
Unfortunately, we forgot to think of it. Let us start with a lady over here who... insured with you.
Mm-hmm.
Mrs. Mills, could you tell me what happened when you insured with...
Well, I didn't actually. My husband did.
Yeah.
And I lost my husband in a car crash.
Sorry, could you say
that? In a car accident, yeah. And, my solicitor was fighting it, you know, and they refused to sort of contact him and made all sorts of excuses that, you know, that... they found some medical evidence that, you know, before he signed the policy, he should have looked at it properly, and which was proved in court. It was all a load of trash, you know, and the whole thing. And they kept going on like this, messing us about, and they offered me 500 and stuck at that. And shortly before they came, you know, became, you know, they went sort of liquidation, then we realised what had happened. They kept messing about, you know, and they wouldn't pay up the money. They just kept sort of offering me 500, and that was it.
So the situation was that you'd lost your husband.
Yes,
in
lost my husband. Yes.
So you were left
with three children.
With three
yes,
children.
And they just sort of kept messing about, you know, sort of no particular purpose, you know. I mean, they
Next.
Just. Sort of
Thank you very much.
Well, mine seems quite trivial compared to this woman. And £240 might not seem a lot to you, Mr. Savundra, but it took me a long time to save it up. And I've got to now pay solicitor's costs, plus court fees, to fight this case to get it back.